Today, we will talk about the Indian Ballistic Missile Defence Program. India's nuclear weapon policy has always been no first use against nuclear nations and no use against non-nuclear countries. But with such hostile neighbors and their threats of using nuclear weapons, gave birth to the development of the Ballistic Missile Defence Shield in late 1999. The program is an initiative to develop and deploy a multi-layered ballistic missile defense system to protect our country from ballistic missile attacks. The work for its development started with two phases. Phase 1 of the program has been completed, while Phase 2 is under development. Phase 1 is focused on intercepting missiles with a range of up to 3,000 kilometers, basically focusing Pakistan's missile arsenal. It includes advanced air defense and Prithvi defense vehicle. Phase 2 will be capable of intercepting missiles up to 5,000 kilometers, and it is under development. It includes AD-1 and AD-2 interceptors. It was initially planned to complete both Phase 1 and 2 by 2016. But, as of November 2022, Phase 1 has been completed, and first test flight of the Phase 2 interceptor has been conducted. According to the DRDO chief, Phase 2 will be concluded by 2025. Since this is a strategic program, we may never know the cause of the delay. Some of the reasons may be the development of a new Prithvi defense vehicle to replace Prithvi air defense, or the development of next generation control system, navigation, and propulsion for Phase 2 interceptors to achieve a high degree of accuracy even in hypersonic speed. But the question remains, can BMD Phase 2 intercept next-generation missiles, including hypersonic glide vehicle, hypersonic cruise missile, and hypersonic quasi-ballistic missile? Have you ever wondered why India does not have ship-based ballistic missile defense, like Aegis combat system? Well, Phase 2 missiles can be launched from both ship and surface. Each ground-based vehicle can carry 6 AD-1 or 2 AD-2 missiles, while Phase 1 missiles can only launch from the surface. Ballistic Missile Defense Shield mainly consists of three components: Swordfish radar, for long-range surveillance and fire control, Command and Control Center, and Missile Launcher. First, target will be detected by long-range tracking radar, followed by tracking and classification of the target, whether the target is a cruise missile or a ballistic missile or a satellite. Then, the information will be transferred to the multifunction fire control radar, which will do a high level of tracking and classification of the target. Let's consider the target is a ballistic missile, then fire control radar will provide which type of ballistic missile, flight altitude, speed, and other critical information to the command and control center. With permission, the interceptor will be launched to eliminate the target. Fire control radar also provides mid-course updates to the interceptor. Now let's talk about all the missiles and radar one by one. Prithvi Air Defense, PAD, also known as Pradyumna Ballistic Missile Interceptor, is an exo-atmospheric anti-ballistic missile based on the Prithvi surface-to-surface ballistic missile. PAD is a two-stage missile. The first stage uses solid-fueled, and the second stage uses liquid-fueled with an oxidizer. It can intercept incoming ballistic missiles at an altitude of 80 kilometers. The missile is equipped with maneuver thrusters that can generate a lateral acceleration of more than 5G. It has the capability to engage the medium-range or 2,000 kilometers class of ballistic missiles at a speed of Mach 5. It uses gimbaled directional warhead technology that can destroy the target anywhere without considering its trajectory. Guidance is provided by an inertial navigation system, with mid-course updates from ground-based radar and active radar homing in the terminal phase. During various tests, it has successfully destroyed targets at an altitude of 50 and 75 kilometers. Advanced Air Defense, AAD, also known as Ashvan Ballistic Missile Interceptor, is an endo-atmospheric anti-ballistic missile. AAD can intercept up to 1,500 km class ballistic missiles at an altitude of 30 km. To destroy incoming targets, it uses a hit-to-kill warhead. It is a single-stage, solid-fueled missile with a 200 km maximum range. For greater maneuverability, it features siliconized carbon jet vanes. Maximum speed is nearly Mach 5, and can take turns from plus 25 Gs to plus 30 Gs. The guidance mechanism is same as Prithvi Air Defense, an inertial navigation system with mid-course updates from ground-based radar, and active radar homing in the terminal phase. During testing, it destroyed the target up to an altitude of 16 kilometers. Prithvi Defense Vehicle, PDV, is an exo-atmospheric anti-ballistic missile. It is a two-stage missile, and both stages are powered by solid propellants. It is designed to replace the Prithvi Air Defense from the PAD and AAD combination. PDV has the same range as PAD, but its flight altitude, guidance, and control system are enhanced. It can intercept up to medium-range or 3,000 km class ballistic missiles at an altitude of 150 km with hit-to-kill warhead. Guidance is provided by a ring laser gyro-based inertial navigation system and redundant micro-navigation system in mid-course, and imaging infrared homing in the terminal phase. On April 27, 2014, DRDO successfully conducted the first test of the PDV missile. Follow-on tests were also conducted successfully in 2017 and 2019. Prithvi Defense Vehicle Mark II is an anti-satellite weapon. It is a three-stage missile. The first two stages are powered by solid propellants and a kill vehicle in the third stage. It can intercept satellites and ballistic missiles at an altitude of 1,200 kilometers. Guidance is provided by a ring laser gyro-based inertial navigation system and redundant micro-navigation system in mid-course, and imaging infrared homing in the terminal phase. It has the capability to shoot down targets moving at 10 kilometers per second in orbits. It also has maneuver thrusters that can generate lateral acceleration to increase accuracy. Some reports suggest it has the capability of exo-atmospheric interception of intercontinental ballistic missiles. On March 27, 2019, DRDO tested PDV Mark II during an operation codename Mission Shakti. The target of the test was a satellite present in a low Earth orbit, which was hit with a kinetic kill vehicle. Swordfish is an Indian active electronically scanned array, long-range, target acquisition, and fire control radar for the BMD system. The radar was specifically developed to counter ballistic missile threats. Initially, the Swordfish long-range tracking radar has a range of 600 kilometers to 800 kilometers and can spot objects as small as a cricket ball. This radar is an acknowledged derivative of the Israeli ELM-2080 Green Pine long-range radar, which is the critical component of Israel's aero-missile defense system. However, it differs from the Israeli system as it employs Indian transmit-receive modules, signal processing, computers, and power supplies. It is also more powerful than the base Green Pine system and was developed to meet India's specific BMD needs. After multiple independently targetable reentry vehicle or MIRV development taking place in China and Pakistan, DRDO plans to upgrade the capacity of Swordfish radar. The upgrade Swordfish radar is known as Super Swordfish or Very Long Range Tracking Radar, has a range of 1,500 kilometers and can spot 3 inches diameter objects. It can detect and track 200 targets simultaneously at a speed of over Mach 12. Swordfish radar detects over 10 successful missile interceptions that include 2 exo-atmospheric hit-to-kill missions. As per some report, DRDO is also developing a long-range radar, like United States long-range discrimination radar. Maybe the radar will use in Phase 2. AD-1 is a long-range interceptor missile designed for both low exo-atmospheric and endo-atmospheric interception of ballistic missiles, as well as aircraft. It can intercept up to intermediate range or 5,000 kilometers class ballistic missiles and can travel at hypersonic speed. It is propelled by a two-stage solid motor and equipped with advanced control system, navigation, and guidance algorithm to precisely guide the vehicle to the target. Guidance is provided by an inertial navigation system in mid-course, and Ka-band active RF seeker in the terminal phase. It has maneuver thrusters that can generate a lateral acceleration to increase accuracy. On November 2, 2022, DRDO conducted a successful maiden flight test of AD-1 interceptor, with all BMD weapon system elements located at different geographical locations. AD-2 is an exo-atmospheric anti-ballistic missile. It can intercept up to intermediate range, or 5,000 km class, ballistic missiles. It will be propelled by a solid motor, and can travel at hypersonic speed. It will have 7 maneuver thrusters that can generate more lateral acceleration as compared to AD-1, to increase accuracy. Guidance is provided by an inertial navigation system in midcourse, and imaging infrared homing in the terminal phase. It will be comparable to the American SM-3 missile. Like SM-3, AD-2 can also intercept satellites in low Earth orbit. According to some report, Phase 1 is a technology demonstrator, and is deployed in a limited number. Unlike Phase 1, Phase 2 missile are designed as anti-ballistic missile. If you are wondering how India will defend itself against nuke-tipped cruise missile, Advanced Air Defense, AAD, and AD-1 interceptors are also capable of neutralizing cruise missiles. Apart from AAD and AD-1, India also has other missile systems to intercept cruise missile. In the future, India will have a 6-layered air defense system, laser-based CIWS, 30 km Akash, 70 km MRSAM, 150 km XRSAM, 400 km S-400, and BMD. That's it for today. See you in the next video.